Welcome back students. In your last video, you have studied about the functions of a skeletal system, about different kinds of bones found in our skeleton or in our body. Okay? Today, we will study about the joints. We will study about the joints. Actually, joints are the places where two bones join with each other. Okay? Joints are the places where two bones meet or join with each other. Okay? Two bones meet at joints. Meet at joints. Okay? Joints have the bones and therefore the body parts to move. Actually, there are two types of joints. Two types of joints. First one is movable joint and movable and its opposite immovable joints. Movable joints are the joints that can move and that can allow the bone to move, but immovable joints don't allow the bones to move. Okay, the definition is so simple. It is clear in their names. It is movable joint. It means it allows movement, but it does not allow any movement. Okay, some joints like the bones of the skull. In our skull, only our lower jaw is moving. I have told you already. Okay, but in our skull, our lower jaw is moving, but all the bones in the skull are not moving. Okay, it means there are immovable joints in our skull. The body makes a special liquid and oil. The joints make a movement smooth and easy. Special covers keep in this oily liquid and help to hold joints together. As you all know that there is a lubricant required in any automobile for the smooth working of any machinery. Okay, it requires oiling time to time. It requires oiling time to time. That is called lubrication, we can say, or lubricants. The oil that we pour are known as lubricants. And lubricants are required for the smoother working of any machine. And our body is also like a machine. Then for smoother working of our bones of our body, we require, there is a oily liquid. That is a oily liquid, okay? That fills in the joints. Now we will study about the types of movable joints. The types of movable joints. I have told you about the joints. Joint is the place where two bones meet. Joints are the places where two bones meet. And there are two kinds of joints: movable joints, immovable joints. Movable joints allows movement. Allows movement of the bone, but immovable joints do not allow movement. Okay? Now we will study about the different kinds of movable joints, about the various kinds of movable joints found in our body. There are various kinds of movable joints found in our body. First one is hinge joint. Hinge joint. Actually, we can move with the help of joint. If there is no joint, we can't move that body part. The body part that has no joint, we can't move it. Okay? We can move the part only having the movable joint. The part that are having movable joints, we can move them. Okay? Hinge joint. First of all, we'll talk about hinge joint. It allows the bone to move in only in one direction.
It can move only in one direction. It is found in knees and elbows. Suppose that you can move your elbow here, but you can't move your elbow in opposite direction. Okay? It means knee joint allows of movement only in one direction. Okay? Second one is pivot joint. Pivot joint, this joint occurs where the skull meets the first vertebra. Our skull meets the first vertebra here. Okay? It allows some amount of circular motion. By turning our skull there, okay? Because there is a pivot joint which allows only circular motion in some amount, okay? It's found in our skull. It's called joint in the vertebra. Okay? Now, ball and socket joint. Third one is ball and socket joint. Ball and socket joints are found in our shoulders, our hip bones, okay? Shoulder, hip bones. In the joint, the round ball-like end of a bone fits into the socket. There is a socket and round ball-like end of a bone. Ball-like end of a bone fits into this socket, okay? This joint allows one bone to rotate and make circular movements. Okay? The hip and the shoulder joints are ball and socket joints, okay? Now we study about the sliding joint. Fourth one is wrist. The bones at the joint slide over each other. It is found in our wrist, ankles. Okay. Now, it's all about the joints. You have to study the book well. In your book, some more examples of the joints are given. If you have any problem, then you can ask me, okay? Yes. Now I am going to start the next system. Still we have studied about the skeletal system. Now we will study about the muscular system. What? Muscular system, okay? About the muscles. In addition to bones, cartilage and muscles also help us in movement. Bones help us in movement. Because there are movable and movable joints allow the bones to move. But there are more things, cartilage and muscles. Now what is cartilage? Actually, cartilage is a tough elastic substance. It holds the bones together at the joint. Tough elastic substance. bone. Hold the bone at joints. This is all about the cartilage. Cartilage is a simple thing that the elastic substance that holds the bone at the joint. Okay? Without cartilage, the bone would rub against each other. Bones will scratch each other, okay? And we are out. Some organs like the nose and ears have cartilage too. Our organs, nose and ears have cartilage, okay? It protects our bone. It protects our bone. Also protects our bone. Okay? Now you see here, what is cartilage? If somebody asks you about cartilage, then you can tell that it is a tough elastic substance. It is a tough elastic substance that holds the bone at the joints. Okay? And it also protects our bone. Now we study about the muscles. Muscles holds the bones together. Okay? Muscles hold the bone together and make movement possible. There are muscles all over the body. There are many muscles. There are muscles all over our body. Okay? And they lie over the skeleton and under the skin. So muscles lie over the skeleton. Over our skeleton but under our skin. Okay? And between bones and our skin there are muscles. And only muscles allow movement. Without muscles we can't move. Okay? Muscles are attached to bones by tendons. Attached to bones with the help of tendons. Okay? What is tendon? Tendon is a strong fiber. It is a strong fiber. There are many muscles within the body. For example, the heart, the stomach have muscles. Okay, muscles have body parts to move. They also give us strength to walk. Muscles give us strength to do work. Okay, now muscles call movement by pulling, by tightening, but muscles cannot push. They can pull, but cannot push. Cannot push. Do you know what pull and push? Do you know what pull and push? Pull means and push means to throw away and to take something near you, okay, towards you. That is pulling something, okay. Suppose that whenever you are opening any door, there is written pull or push, okay. Then pull means and push to throw away. To move away from you, okay? Yes. We take time to pull on the bones at the joint. Look at the box to understand the better. You can look into the box. This is the box that is in your book, okay? Bending the arm. Here the process of bending the arm. Whenever you are bending the arm, the whole process is given. How the muscles work. How the muscles work. Actually, this bending is allowed due to the movement of muscles. Without muscles, we can't bend our arm. We can't hold anything, we can't move, we can't do any work, okay? When the muscles at the front of the upper arm means this. When the muscle at the front of the upper arm, there are two muscles at the front and at the back. There are two muscles at the front side and at the back side of the arm, okay? The forearm bends at the elbow and when the front muscle relaxes, when this muscle relaxes, okay? And the one at the back of it becomes tightened. Is tight and it becomes left. The arm straightens out. Okay. Now the types of muscles. Actually, there are three types of muscles. In your body and the names are voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles and cardiac muscles. There are three kinds of muscles. First one, voluntary muscles. Second one, involuntary muscles. And third one is cardiac muscles. Okay. First of all, we study about voluntary muscles. Heading is types of muscles. First one is voluntary muscles. These muscles are those we can move or stop moving at will. Means these muscles are in under our control. These muscles are in under our control. We can control the movement of these muscles. We can control the movement of these muscles. We can control the movement of these muscles. Okay. Now, there are three kinds of muscles I told you. First one is voluntary muscles, and what is about the voluntary muscles? Actually, voluntary muscles are those whose movement can be controlled by us. We can control their movements. Okay. Can you think of any other parts that we can move when we want? Yes. We can move our hands, our legs. We can move it up. They are bent and therefore negative stiff muscles. These muscles are long and cylindrical. These muscles are long and cylindrical. And these are also known as stripped muscles. Clear? Voluntary muscles are the muscles that we can control their movements. These are long and cylindrical. These are also known as stripped muscles. Okay? Now, involuntary muscles. The muscles whose movement we can't control. We can't control their movement. The muscles that we cannot control. Voluntary muscles we can control, but involuntary muscles we cannot control. Simple definition. The blood vessels, stomach, food pipe, and intestines are some parts of the voluntary muscles. These muscles are short and spindle shaped. They are also known as smooth muscles, short and spindle shaped. Short and spindle shaped. Also known as smooth muscles. What is their other name? Smooth muscles. It is clear about the involuntary muscles. We cannot control their movements. These are short and spindle shaped. And these are also known as smooth muscles. Okay. Now, the third one is cardiac muscles. Actually, the muscles in our heart. The muscles in our heart is known as or are known as cardiac muscles. Muscles. These muscles work all our lives and pumping blood through the body. Cardiac muscles look like voluntary muscles and are branched. Look like voluntary muscles. These look like voluntary muscles but not voluntary. Okay? These look like voluntary muscles but they are found in our heart and they live through our lives in our whole life. Okay? And the pumping, what is the work of these muscles? They pump blood. Your body. Okay? Yep. Now I think the chapter has been completed. And you all have understood the chapter? But listen to me carefully. These are not holidays. You have to work harder. Okay? You have to study the whole book and whole chapter. If you have any problem, then you can ask me anytime. Okay, students? Now, thank you. Have a nice day.